Hi guys, so I am very interested to start this full stack development series. In this series we are going to learn about so many technologies like front end technologies and some back end technologies like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, PHP, Perl, PHP, MySQL, like that. And any additional technologies can be added if I missed in this list, so don't worry about it. So in this series we are going to learn about these type of full stack development technologies. Okay, so this is just like an introduction video or like whatever you can think of. So here I am going to show about some simple HTML format and about some CSS basics. So HTML is nothing but hypertext markup language. So it is not any programming language like C or C++. It is a design language. So you need to remember this point. And this is what the HTML structure will look like. I mean, this is the code that HTML structure will look like. And you will need to write the code in between the body tags. You will get to know what is the tag, what is an element, what is the content, like that. And this is the simple structure of HTML HTML code. And if you want to know, and I'm going to show about some CSS fundamentals. And this is what a CSS box model. So basically CSS is used to style an element, to an HTML element. So if you just give this, if you use a button, so it will just create a button by its default properties. So some HTML parsers or some HTML compilers or some, sorry, HTML parsers. So some HTML parsers consist of some predefined or inbuilt styling properties in order to style for some elements. So that properties and styling will be rendered when you given in the HTML document. But if you want to change the styling to your elements, then you need to change and you need to style with the help of this CSS properties. So basically the CSS means here I am going to show about the box model. So box model means it is nothing but a box. So every HTML element occupies a box, a box shape. So this is what we can look here, and in middle of it we can see that there is a content, and outside of the content, that is border and the content. In between this content and border we are having padding. So if you want some enough space, and if you want some space between border and content, then you can use this padding property. And if you want to achieve some space between a border and outside of the space of the another container or any element, then you can achieve that space by this property margin. So this is the CSS box model. These two are basic things in order to start the full stack development. So I will start some new series I announced that announcement in my Discord channel, but this is not the series that I am going to start. The series is about the buffer overflow exploits. In that series I will explain about the buffer overflow exploits, how to write buffer overflow exploit, like that. That is taking somewhat time, so in order to not to waste the time, I started this full stack series. I hope you like watching this video. Please do like and subscribe if you like the content. Have a great day.